Here we are at stage four of the Santos Tour Down Under. The first start here at Modbury in Tea Tree Gully. It's a 127-kilometre course today, Pat, for the professional riders, but also for the amateur riders. There's the Bupa Challenge Tour. This is a really exciting stage. There'll be some 7,000 or 8,000 riders. For some, it'll be very exciting and nerve-wracking. It'll be the first time they've done anything like this. And for others, it's just the excitement of seeing that sea of jerseys out there on the course.
And this afternoon, we have the pleasure to say hello to Jay Weatherill, the Premier of South Australia. Could you please tell us a little bit about the reason you're competing in the Governor's 10?
Well, he asked me, and it's always a good idea to do what the Governor asks. But it's a great cause as well, raising money for cancer research and all of the area of promoting that incredibly fantastic cause. And I'm getting into bike riding. My wife is a very keen cyclist and she's got me into bike riding. So I've done Amy's ride and now I'm sort of migrating into the Bupa Challenge, which is great.
I'm here with Professor Brenda Wilson, the Chief Executive of Cancer Council SA. Personally and professionally, what does Ride for a Reason mean for you?
From my own personal reasons, my father died from Hodgkin's lymphoma a number of years ago. I've had several women friends who've been diagnosed with breast cancer, a male friend diagnosed with prostate cancer, and a stepfather who died this year from bowel cancer. So I have lots of personal reasons to ride. It's a really great cause. The Governor's 10 raised more than $50,000 last year, and as a team we're hoping to beat that so that we can invest that money into the best cancer research in South Australia, grow our research presence here, attract and retain the best cancer researchers in South Australia, and it's just a good all-round event. To get fit, it's just fabulous.
So we've climbed out from Golden Grove Road, turned right, headed up here towards the Gould Creek area. As you can see in the background, this is some of the most magnificent scenery in this particular stage. We go down the hill here, back up the other side. It's an excellent ride. From a spectator point of view today, it's a course that goes from A to B and zigzags through various places. It's important that people stay clear of the roads themselves, Pat, because of the amount of riders that will be on the course. But there are opportunities to go and, for example, see the King of the Mountain. So Pat, here we are at the top of Humbug Scrub, and it's really a bit deceptive because you keep thinking that this is the top and this is the top and you're not quite there, and then you do the sweeping left-hand bend and you finally find yourself here at the top. And so after the climb, what do we got now?
Yeah, nice fast ascent. It's fairly steep to begin with, 12-15%. Nice wide road, coarse asphalt. If you're in the Bupa Challenge, keep a bit of room, trying to get too close to the rider in front of you. So we'd like to keep it safe today at the Bupa Challenge. And for the pro riders, good opportunity for the adventurers to have a dig midway through the stage.
From a spectator point of view today, see the King of the Mountain at Humbug Scrub, and then for people to make their way around towards the back, what I'll call the back straight area, which is along that valley road from through Springton, Eden Valley, and then on to Tanunda. Some people may find it easier just to go to Tanunda and enjoy the atmosphere then for the end of the event itself. So the riders come into here, into Tanunda. It's a very fast finish here into Tanunda, Pat, for both the amateur riders as well as the professionals. How do you see that?
It's always spectacular finish to watch, probably one of the most spectacular of the week. Basically because the run-in into the finish is so fast, they'll be reaching speeds close to 70 kilometres per hour. Sprint finish, I predict, but a reasonably large group. You know, you can never say in the Santos Tour Down Under, so many things can happen. There's so many different race scenarios. I'm picking quite a reasonably large group coming together towards the end. And a couple of Uni SA riders up there, that'll make for a great day.
So for everybody that's intending to participate in Stage 4 of the Santos Tour Down Under, whether that be as a Bupa Challenge Tour participant, whether you're riding for a reason or you're a professional, enjoy the ride. We look forward to seeing you here in Tanunda, Barossa Valley.